Today's lesson will be about creating texture in the Colorbyte version 11 front end and then printing it on the UV84 DTS printer. So I've imported my image into Colorbyte, and after you select it, you can go to Image, Create Texture. The first thing you'll see is your original color image on the left and a grayscale representation of that image on the right. Texture is made by manipulating the grayscale image to get really dark areas, really light areas, and a contrast in between, and that'll put down varying amounts of ink. So the darker areas will get more ink, and the lighter areas will get less, and then the grayscale in between will get those varying amounts. The first thing we want to do is choose our base spot color. So we can choose to build texture in just white, just clear, or by selecting the duotone, we'll build in clear and white. For the UV84 DTS, we want to select clear and white, so the duotone. Next, you have your filters. These filters can be turned off and on by right-clicking the text on the right of the filter. Invert will invert the grayscale image, making your dark areas light and your light areas dark. The next two filters, histogram and curves, do similar things. The idea behind these is that we want to create a good amount of contrast in the image, making our darks really dark, our lights really light, and having good midtones in between so we get that varying feel when the image is eventually printed. So I'm going to use curves. I'm going to turn the curves on, that way I can see what my changes are doing to the image. And it's good to usually start with a typical S curve, kind of like this. So that'll make the dark areas darker and the light areas lighter. So you can play around with these points to give you the type of contrast that you're looking for in the image. So the next filter is Edge. And this gives you the option to do embossing or blurring. But for this image, we're going to do sharpen. Now you'll notice if I increase the sharpness, my image isn't changing. Always want to make sure we right click and turn on the filter so we can see what it's doing as we change. The last filter here is choke. And this is good sometimes when you have thin lines, because when you print a lot of ink, it can sometimes bleed out and enter into other parts of the image. So by choking, you can ensure that those thin lines don't enter into the other areas. So we'll do a choke of 10 on this particular image. We want to add this to a new layer and select OK. So you can see we now have a new texture layer over here in our layer viewer, which is overprinted over our original color image. I want to see where the texture is. You can go to View and Show 3D. This will give you a 3D representation of your color and your texture layer. So once our file is done, we can go File, Send to Rip, and choose our UV84 DTS texture queue. So once our image is in the rip, we can right-click the job and hit print, and this will print to a PRN file. A prompt will then come up asking where we want to save this file. We'll save it to the desktop. And now we can navigate over to our print control software. So you'll notice I have desktop selected, but I don't see my image. If I right-click and hit refresh, now our image is there, ready to be printed. But before we print, we need to go to Print Options and change our spot processing options so that we get our texture or our thickness to our image. So our standard texture mode, we put a thickness of 2 for the white and a thickness of 2 for the clear. And then under Layer Mode, we select Texture. Once you've made these changes, you can hit Apply, come back to File Select, double click, and your file is ready to be printed.